So we're at the new Dartmouth bus terminal in the city next to Halifax by the Halifax Harbour. So this is a huge terminal that took 30 years to build, and it's an extremely huge, as far as I'm concerned, extravagant waste of money the way that this is built. But hey, it looks nice to the eye, but it's really difficult to use. It's like it's the length of a city block. You get off a bus, you got to walk like 10, 15 minutes to get to find your bus stop. So what I'm going to do now is I'm not going to talk too much. I'm just going to ride around and give you a tour on the outside of this thing. And after that, I'll give you a tour on the inside. So here we go. Enjoy. I'm going pretty fast in this wheelchair, so it won't take very long to get a good tour of this thing. Now, this thing is huge. I mean, even cities with 50 million people don't build bus terminals this big. And this population of Dartmouth is only like, what, 80,000? I don't know. Somebody made some big money to build this fancy dandy thing that is way too big. So I know you might be having a hard time hearing me with all the wind, but so I'm just giving you a quick run around to see, so you can see what it looks like. And then after that, I shall go on the inside. So right now the speed that I'm driving at is basically like a fast jog. If you were trying to do this, to run all the way around this far so far, you'd be pretty exhausted. So I just went around a city block. And it's not going to take very long to go around the other side and finish. And after that, I'm going to turn around and go back and talk to that supervisor that was sitting there chatting about whatever. So I hope you're enjoying this tour. I'm going to do an inside tour right after this. High-tech wheelchair. No. I don't know if you noticed that my wheelchair went out of control there, where the caster started wobbling really bad, which is what it often does. So I'm back to the entrance that I can't get in. So I'm going to turn around and go talk to the supervisor. So now I'm sitting at the multi-million dollar new Dartmouth bus terminal, sitting here in my wheelchair, and I'm going to show you this ridiculous thing that they did here with this entrance. This building is top-notch, super expensive, and people in wheelchairs can't even get in the building, and I'll show you why. So here we go. Just give you a little scoot around, look around. So it looks like a really wonderful entrance. Here's a button right here. You push it, and the first door opens. Now, watch this. You come in a little bit. What do you see? You see another post right there. And what does it say on it? It says push to exit. I cannot open the second door because there's no button to open it. And where do they put the button? They put it way over there on the other side of the entrance, up against that wall. So how does a person in a wheelchair get into this building? I can't go over there and try to back up and line back up and try to open, get into that door while it's opening. I can't believe that they spent all this money to build this entrance and people in wheelchairs can't get in the building. And I told them about this and they never fixed it. Pretty crazy, eh? They put a button right there for me to get in, and there's no button on the inside for me to open the other door.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's way over there and you can't get to it. Can't even get in the building if you're in a wheelchair. So now you're having a look at the stupidity of how they built this. And I told Metro, Halifax Metro Transit, about the fact that people in wheelchairs can't get in this building, and you think they're gonna fix it? All you gotta do is put another button on that second post in there so I can open the second door. But no, they don't listen to people in wheelchairs. So there's your report on the new bridge terminal bus stop for Dartmouth, yeah, and people in wheelchairs can't get in the building. This is the downstairs ground level of the new Dartmouth Bridge Terminal. So I'm going to do another quick little run through, and people don't want to have cameras on them, so I don't want to do that. And after I do this first floor, I'm going to go to the second floor. So now you're getting an idea what this place looks like and how big it is. Hello. and we'll go down to this end. There's the entrances that they just never been made aware now, they don't work right. And there we go. Oops, there's the upstairs. And I'm doing a video series of this place. It's pretty neat having my own vehicle to drive around in. Okay, now I'm going to get into the elevator and you'll come with me and we'll go upstairs and I shall go out of the building by the upstairs door. Okay, nice big door. There we go. So now you're getting to learn to see what it's like to be in a wheelchair trying to roll around. But this is a neat little short little video I'm doing here. Look at that. And now there's that second level. Second level of this this building is pretty amazing. And we'll go here, we'll show you a little bit this way. And there's the city over there, and there's Halifax on the other side. But what I'm showing you is that this is a kind of a neat building, and now there's no power door here, there must be one on the other side. There we go. It's boiling in here because it's so sunny today. And I'm going to go outside and explain to you what we're looking at, where we're sitting. This is actually a public transit bus terminal in Dartmouth. So now you're going to have a hard time hearing me, and I'm talking really close to the camera. So we're actually up out of an elevated area here, which is pretty high. And what they did is they provided a walkway back here so people could walk from the main street that's way down there and walk over, walk all the way across, and end up in the Concagus elevator to come down. But not many people are using this entrance. The reason they did it this way is so that people wouldn't walk in where the buses are coming in and out, so that they would cause a hazard and cause an accident. And they put a nice little park here. This used to be a wilderness forest up here. It took 30 years to build this terminal, millions of dollars. And in many ways, it's a fantastic building. But in other ways, it's not very functional. It's going to be very, very expensive to maintain. But all in all, I have to say that it's quite revolutionary. It's quite amazing. I hope you can hear me because there's a lot of wind. And I'm talking right above my camera here, right on top of the microphone, so you might still not be able to hear me. So I'm going to go over here. And I'm going to turn around and show you where the bus terminal is. And so that's the McDonald Bridge up here. See? And that's the city of Halifax across the harbor. And there's the new bus terminal. Thank you for watching.